Hi, it's Ms. Barnacle again. Here is another module dealing with division. This time we're going to talk about long division and what happens when it takes us a little longer than 24 divided by 6 to get an answer. Sometimes you have a bigger problem, and here is a cute little thing to learn how to do it or remember. Does McDonald's serve cheeseburgers? So we're going to go through this, and I'm going to show you the process. You divide, multiply, subtract, compare, and bring down. And all of these notes are going to be on the Open Campus site so that you can download them and use them to study with. So when you do this, I'm going to work one of the harder problems for you that doesn't necessarily come out even. It comes out with a remainder so that you can see what we do with not only this little saying, but also what happens when it doesn't come out even and you need to check your answer. So we're going to go through this. Okay, so I'm going to work this problem out for you. This is long division, and it's going to use our little saying, does McDonald's serve cheeseburgers? And then when we're done, we're going to have a remainder. And we talked about that just a little bit in the first module, but this will be a better explanation and you'll be able to see it. So we say, how many times does 17 divide into 89? Because we can't divide 17 into 8, so we had to move over to the 9. 17 divides into 89 5 times. So that's does. McDonald's means multiply, so we're going to multiply 17 times 5. And when we do that, we get 7 times 5 is 35. And 5 times 1 is 5, plus 3 makes 8. And serve means subtract, so we're going to subtract these from each other. 9 minus 5 is 4. 8 minus 8 is 0, so I don't need that. And then we ask ourselves, we compare. There's the cheese part of it. And when we compare, we say, is 17, which is my divisor, bigger than the remainder that I got, which is 4? And yes, it is, so I'm good to go. So then B, burgers, bring down the next number. So when I do that, I do my whole saying over again. 17 divides into 42 about 2 times, and then I multiply. 2 times 7 is 14, 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1 makes 3, and then I'm going to subtract. I have to borrow and make that a 12, and that 4 goes down to a 3, and then when I do my subtraction, 12 minus 4 is 8, 3 minus 3 is 0, so I don't need to put that there. And then I compare. Is my divisor 17 bigger than 8, my remainder? Yes, it is. So I'm good to go. I bring down my last digit, and that's a 0. So then I'm going to divide one last time. 17 goes into 80 about 4 times. So when I do that multiplication, 4 times 7 is 28. 4 times 1 is 4, plus 2 makes 6. And when I do this subtraction, I borrow again, and that makes that 10, which when I subtract, I get 2. And when I borrowed, I changed that 8 to a 7, so 7 minus 6 is 1. And then that leaves me a remainder of 12. Now, in order to check and make sure that we did this correctly, we're going to multiply, and that's 524, our quotient, our answer that we got, times 17. And when we do the multiplication, 7 times 4 is 28. 7 times 2 is 14. 14 plus 2 makes 16. 7 times 5 is 35. 35 plus 1 makes 36. And remember to move over a space when we go to the tens place. And we do 1 times 4 is 4. I don't need these anymore. 1 times 2 is 2. 1 times 5 is 5. And then you add that. And when I add going down, 8 plus 0 is 8. 6 plus 4 makes 10. Carry the 1. 6 plus 2 makes 8. Plus that 1 makes 9. 3 plus 5 makes 8. And I get 8,908. Now I'm pretty close to 8,920, but I still have my remainder. So to get your remainder and see if it's actually the answer, you want to take your remainder 12 and you want to add it to this total that I just got. So I'm going to do that right here in this small space. I have 8,908 and I'm going to add my remainder. 8 plus 2 is 10. 1 plus 1 makes 2, and bring the other digits down because I didn't have to do anything to them. And I notice that I get 8,920, and that's exactly what I started with. So that way you can check and make sure that you did it correctly. Okay, that's all I have to say about this lesson. I hope that you download the notes so that you can study and take the self-assessment that I have on Blackboard for you.